Okay, so here's a little bonus video on how to do more tricks and tips with patterns, etc. We've got our little composition that we just finished in the last video, and I told you before that you had the option to do to go to edit and to define a pattern. Well, you also have the option to choose which part of this you'd like to have as a pattern. To do that, what you can do is grab the marquee tool, which is hiding over here on the toolbar. It's the second one down. You get there with the letter M. And all you have to do is click and drag any part of this, and whatever is in there will become the pattern. So let's say I wanted a pattern that did something like that. Whatever is in the marching ants will become the pattern. Edit, define the pattern. There it is, that little bit right there. We'll call this one bottom of circle and say OK. The next thing I want to do, though, is to deselect. I have a little selection, the marching ants. I don't want to fill this with a pattern because it'll just fill that. So say select, deselect, or the shortcut is Command D or Control D on a PC, deselect. Now I'm going to give myself a new blank layer. Remember, anytime we did a blank layer in Photoshop, whichever layer we have selected, the blank layer will go above. So in this case, I want to click on the top layer and say, give me a blank layer, and I want to go fill, edit, and fill that layer with what? A pattern. What pattern? The last one in the list. And it's got all kinds of fun stuff you can do, especially in CC here. It's got some crazy stuff, but I'm just going to take that pattern and say, okay, there's that pattern. Maybe we like that. Maybe we save that out. If we don't like it, Command Z is undo, or Control Z is undo on a PC. Well, so in CC, you've got all kinds of different ways to use the pattern. In earlier versions of Photoshop, you're not going to have as many. I'll just show you really quickly what you can get out of this that you couldn't get in the other ones. If I go to scripted patterns here, I've got some options to brick fill or cross weave or random fill or spiral or all kinds of stuff here. Let's just take the brick fill idea for a second, and I'm just going to say OK. And here I have this brick fill, this kind of random piece going back and forth that kind of fills up that pattern, changes the color a little bit. Kind of nice, kind of like that. If you wanted to do a spiral, though, the best way to do a spiral would be to have something kind of long and tall here as the piece that gets copied. So let's try that. I'm going to take the rectangle, and I'm going to click up in the top there and maybe down like that, and a long, tall piece like that. And go to Edit and Define Pattern, and we can call this Spiral 1 and say OK. Remember now to deselect, Command D or Control D on a PC. I still got that blank layer over there. This time I'm going to go to Edit and Fill with what? A pattern. What pattern? The last one in the list. But instead of choosing Brick Fill this time, I'll choose Spiral. The kids love this. I don't know why, they just do. Say OK. And what you get is this little spiral that starts from the center out, spins its way around, and like I said, longer, taller pieces are going to work a whole bunch more interestingly than the shorter, fatter pieces. So there's a really cool little spiral. And this came from that design. Might be an interesting concept to show the kids, you know, hey, let's work this out, and then let's try and make a spiral, and let's see who can figure out which spiral came from which piece of art. That'll kind of make the connection to them with the color scheme and the balance and the different objects and things that happen to be inside this. But definitely, you like that, save it out, file, save as. And you might put it in the same place. Go to our JPEGs for class here, but this time I'm going to call this one Spiral 1. And I'll do underscore and my initials, just in case. And I don't want to save it as a Photoshop document. I'll save it as a JPEG, and I'll hit save. And again, it's very small. Say OK. So that's one way to do it. I'll get rid of that for a second. Now, let's throw in one last little bonus thing here, which can really make your head explode, but just go with it. Here's this top layer. What I'd like to do is I'd like to keep all these layers that I've got on the right-hand side, keep all of these guys. But I want to put them together as one layer. So I've got all these guys separate, and I want to do a brand new layer on the top. On a PC, you could do it the same way on a keyboard as on a Mac, just the keys are a little differently, held down differently. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go Shift, so a fistful of keys here, Option, Command, and the letter E. Think of an elevator or an escalator. And look what it did. It gave us a composite layer. One layer of all the other layers put together, still by itself. I'm going to double click on the words layer 3 and call this composite 1. Okay. So here comes a little bit of a fun trick that you can do with the kids. Take this one, this layer here, and we're going to copy this very quickly. And you could do all kinds of fun ways of copying things, but the easiest way to do this is to think of jumping. Command J, Control J on a PC. Notice it made an exact duplicate of the other layer and put it on top. Okay? What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Edit, and this time I'm going to go to Transform and Flip Horizontal. Now, when I do that, it flipped the whole entire picture horizontal, and you can see over here that I've got one layer going one way and one going the other. What I want to do now is blend them. You can blend them, or you can change the opacity, or both. But I'm going to blend them. Let's see what happens if I say, let's do screen here. Now, screen, these darken, these lighten, these are contrast. Let's do screen. Let's see what it did. What? Check that out. This looks like Paul Klee in the 21st century. Holy crap. So we kind of like that. What we could do is keep the thing going here. Let's do a